Samsung, the South Korean company that is one of the world's largest producers of electronic devices. They have become one of the most recognizable names in technology. They account for 20% of South Korea's exports. So how did a struggling rice company end up being one of the biggest technology companies? In today's episode, we will discuss the rise of Samsung. The year is 1910. Lee Byung-chul was born when Japan worked to wipe out Korean culture, language, and history. Luckily, he was born in a landowner's family. The family was willing to leave their properties behind for Chul. Young Chul would look for farmers working at nursery paddy fields and decided to sell their product by starting a rice mill. Although this was an ambitious idea, he did dedicate himself to work strictly on the mill. But having no experience or a strategy in place, the business failed. With no profits coming in, he was forced to shut down. To make things worse, the business went bankrupt. Chul ended up losing most of what he had inherited. For now, he had two options, either to give up or find a different strategy. For his second venture, he decided to go all in by starting a grocery trading store with $2,000. It was called Samsung. The business dealt in exporting green grocery, dried fish produced, fruits, and noodles around the city and to China. Even though the world was at war, Samsung saw a drastic growth in 1945. They were supplying goods throughout Korea and to other countries. By the end of the war, they were one of the largest trading companies. But 5 years after World War II, North Korea invaded South Korea. Most of Korea's factories were damaged. 60% of textile and chemical factories were destroyed. Half of the country's rail was no longer usable. Many farmers and businessmen were driven off their lands and out of their factories. Korea was now one of the poorest countries in the world. The country was in desperate need to repair, and the companies were too young to sustain the economy. One ambitious man with a track record looked at this as an opportunity to start over. The Korean government helped by providing them easy financing. This shift came as a boon for Chul. With financing available and the country in need of pretty much everything, Samsung was just getting started. Following the war, Chul moved to a secure location in Busan and started a sugar refinery. He focused heavily on industrialization, with the goal of helping Korea redevelop itself. He then started a wool factory in 1954, which later became the largest wool factory in the country. From 1958 onwards, Samsung began to expand into other industries such as financing, media, chemicals, shipbuilding. During this expansion, Chul's son, Lee Kun-hee, also joined Samsung. Kun-hee's track record is also impressive to say the least. He completed his studies at George Washington University. He was known for riding horses, racing sports cars. He was the president of the Korean Amateur Wrestling Association and was involved with a professional baseball team and amateur athletics. Lee Byung-chul welcomed his son to work quietly under him as he got involved in machinery, chemicals, and financial services. It wasn't until 1969 when the father and son decided to enter the electronics industry. One of their first electronic product was the black and white televisions. Within a year, Samsung was also in the business of machines and fridges. The late 1970s and early 80s witnessed the rapid expansion of Samsung's technology businesses. The company reached a landmark by producing 5 million TVs. In the late 1980s, Samsung decided to improve their technology by investing heavily in research and development. Investing heavily on R&D is something that they do till today. Sadly, in 1987, the founder Lee Byung-chul passed away due to lung cancer. His son, Kun-hee, took control of Samsung. Kun-hee was known for his bold moves. He wanted to transform Samsung into a global power. His first move was to expand Samsung globally by building factories in the US, Britain, Germany, Thailand, Mexico, Spain, and China. But this expansion came with a cost. The quality started to drop. Fed up with the reputation of making poor quality, Kun-hee famously told his employees to change everything except your wife and children. They started to reinvent and redesign their products. Kun-hee sold off a tenth of the Samsung Group's subsidiaries, downsizing the company to concentrate on three industries: electronics, engineering, and chemicals. According to company legend, in 1995, one of Samsung's first mobile phones did not work as planned. When Kun-hee Lee found out, he visited the factory and reportedly told the staff to burn it down. From the burned-down factory emerged a new series, the Samsung Galaxy Smartphone Series, which quickly not only became the company's most praised product, but also topped annual lists of the best-selling smartphones in the world. Since 2006, the company has been the top-selling global manufacturer of televisions. In 2014, Kunhee was hospitalized with a heart attack, which left him in a coma. Kunhee passed away in 2020. Since then, his son, Lee Jae-young, has taken control of Samsung. It took Samsung two generations to change the entire electronics and smartphone market. Behind it was one man from South Korea who wanted to redevelop his country after a devastating war. Until next time, have a good one.